How easybead works. On the left you see stitch. When you want to design the side pattern you choose loom, and when you want to design the bottom you choose rosette. With rosette never change the number of columns, because then the program will freeze. Only change the rows. 40 is a lot for a bottom, so you can just choose the 20 and then you have enough rows for the bottom, and then you can make your design. But I'm going to do this tutorial for the side pattern, but just wanted to tell you that the program will freeze when you change columns for the rosette. We go to loom. And just have to fix these numbers, because now it's the standard for the side, or for the bottom. Put it like this and then it's okay. Oh, made a little mistake here. It's a bit slow now because I'm recording and I'm designing, so sometimes we have to wait a little. On the right, you can choose the colors you want. You can just scroll to the list till you find the color you want, or you can click palette, then choose a color, and then you get a few colors that look like the color you just selected. You can also type in this here, let's say red, and then you get all the reds that are in here. When you select a color, fill in a bead, and then it appears in this list on the left. I already selected four colors, so they are in the list. What I do first is I fill the whole design with one color. I'm gonna do that with yellow, so select yellow, then choose this bucket, then click on one bead, and then the whole pattern fills up with that color. When you want to make lines, you choose this button. It is draw line. Select a different color, and then you can make lines. Just click the mouse and hold it, and then just pull to the right, and you can adjust how you want it. And when you let go, it's there. You can also make diagonal lines. Now for a little designing. Not really making anything, just filling in a few. Here you change colors, and fill some beads again. Selecting another color. And making more designs. When you're designing and you think those colors aren't really looking good together, you can also always change colors. Let's say we want blue. Choose a blue color. Select the bucket again, and then it is the new color. Because I filled in four beads here with the colors I selected in the beginning, and the pink is still here, and that's why the pink is still in the list. When you select yellow, for instance, and click on the pink bead, you will see that it will disappear from the list. When you want to change a color, oh, my mouse is sometimes doing a bit weird. When you want to change this color in the whole pattern, choose a new color, a dark blue, for instance. Then you go to this green button. It is called Replace. You click on one bead in the color, and then the light blue will change to the dark blue, all the beads that there are in this pattern. You can also add a column with this button, or remove column, add a row, or remove a row. Let's add a column. Click where you want the column and it appears. And then you can just fill in with the colors you like. With this button, you remove a column. Let's remove this one. And then everything just shifts to the new position. Then we have, of course, you can also do that with a row. It works the same. Here you can shift the pattern to the left, to the right, or up, or down. When you click it, it immediately changes. So shift pattern to the left, and then you see that everything goes to the left. There's also an undo button. Very important, because I always make mistakes. And then you see it's coming back here. It is important to save your design with this option, save. When you save it, it will be a .ptnx file. You can only open it in easybead. But it's the only way you can make changes in your design. Every time you save it, you have to click the name again. Click save. Then you get the list with the patterns you already have. I already named it. You click it on the name and then save. And then it is saved again. So it does not work like Word, for instance, where you just say save and then it's saved again. Always have to click on the name. When the design is finished, you can make it export it to an image. And then you can put the image on our Facebook page, for instance. We really like you to share your designs with us. I hope this tutorial was useful.